Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This video will be on how I apply my crystals that last 4+ weeks. I wanted to use different crystal sizes as well as different crystal designs, and I do have two methods of how I normally apply crystals depending of course on what I'm doing, and that is what I'm going to show you guys so that you guys can try this out and see if it works for you. Now there are so many different ways you can apply crystals. Whatever works for you is what matters. So mind you, please try this, see if it works for you, and hopefully it does. So the first thing I did, I do use a base. I use Glam & Glitz acrylic in the color Platinum Pearl, and you need some sort of base when you're doing a full nail of crystals. And then I did use Eternal Beige from Enel Couture, and I used this just for the cuticle area to make the French nail. And I did use OP Eyes polish in another Romantic, and this polish is the one that I'm gonna polish the other two fingernails that have clear acrylic. And I'm just showing you here in case you were gonna do a clear acrylic set and you just put gel polish on top, or if you do a gel manicure and you just do gel polish, how you would apply crystals to those nails, as well as if you use acrylic color or acrylic glitter as a background and then do the crystals. I want to show you as many methods as possible so that you can see what works for you. So I will do two layers of this pink on both fingers at the corners, and then like I previously said, I already used acrylic glitter for the French nail and for the full nail that's going to be blinged out. Now after I do the two layers of polish color, gel polish color, I will do a top coat. And my favorite top coat is Enel Couture, which is the one I'm showing you here. It's a different bottle. It's a new bottle that they decided to do. But it's still the same shiny top coat from Enel Couture. And I do one simple, very, very thin coat. I cure it in the lamp. And then I grab my file and I gently file the top. I don't do a buffer because if you end up over buffing or you buff too much, you can make the finish very smooth and the crystals won't adhere. So I gently file the top of it. That is why I use the top coat to protect the color. So here are the sizes I'm going to be using: 6, 10, 12, and 16. It's just the color that I picked because it has the most different sizes. The best thing to do a full nail with is different sizes. These are also other four crystals that I'm going to be using in different shapes. If I can find the links to these, because I've ordered these like 4 years ago, I will post them down below, but they are from AliExpress. So first we're going to start with the full nail. This is Gummy Jelly from Enel Couture. It is my favorite gel to adhere a full nail crystal, and that is because it is very, very thick and it adheres beautifully. So the method I'm gonna show you here is different, so I hope you understand what I'm showing you guys. I just used a gel brush that I got from AliExpress like 6 years ago, and I apply the gel. It is a little bead I'm using, but mind you, I don't go back to grab more. I use that bead and then I apply it very, very thin. Make sure I fully cover the whole nail, and then I go back into the container and remove anything that's left in my brush, and then I keep on brushing because I want this to be as thin as possible. If it is not thin, it will be bulky and the nail shape will go off. Do not cure that as soon as you're done. When you're done polishing that gel, that gummy jelly, go right on top of that with your favorite gel top coat. It doesn't matter what top coat it is. Like I said, I used Enel Couture and I applied it right on top of that gel. I did not cure it. And then I cleaned the sidewalls because I don't want it to be bulky and to lose its shape. And then I go in with the smallest and second smallest crystals, and I worry about the cuticle area. That is just what works for me and what I do. I've seen methods where you can start at the top and do the whole center and then move yourself from the left or to the right. But this is what works for me. I love to take it level wise. So I usually start off with, like I said, small crystals around the cuticle, sidewalls, and free edge. And then I work my way around to slipping medium to larger crystals. I don't always put large crystals in a full nail simply because sometimes it doesn't make it look right. They stand out too much. They look bulgy. It, to me personally, it's not something I prefer to do. So I like to mix medium sizes, maybe 10, 12s. Rarely do I do 16s in there unless the nail is really long and you can't really tell. But I like to even it out because I want it to look as flawless as possible. And like I said, I don't want any crystals poking out on the sides that take away from the shape of the nail that I'm trying to do. Now I will tell you, when you do apply the gummy jelly and then the gel top coat, after a while, maybe halfway through your nail, you will see that the crystals will be smoothing very slightly, especially if you're lifting the finger or lowering the finger, you know, facing it whichever way, it will move just a tad bit. So before you send the person to put their nail under the lamp or before you put your nail under the lamp, make sure you double check it. Press the crystals inside from the sidewall, from the free edge, so nothing's sticking out. Double, triple check it, and then go into the lamp and fully cure it for a good minute. Now moving on to the French nail, this is about maybe 60-70% of the nail is being covered in crystals. All depends on how long the French will be, but I do the same exact technique. I made sure I had some sort of base that matches the crystals that I choose, and I did it in acrylic. I did file this, and I did dehydrate it with alcohol, and now I'm applying the gummy jelly from Enel Couture, just like I did on the full length nail. But here I'm just making sure I'm keeping it away from the beige pink that I chose. And then I'm making sure it's very thinly. I also clean off the sidewalls and the free edge before going in with the crystals. And for the smile line of the French, I make sure I use the smallest crystals I have, which are number 6 in this color, the AB color crystals. And I do that all around the smile line to start off the shape. And then I move up a size of crystals, which was, I think it was an 8 and a 10 that I used on this one as well. And I work my way down the same way. I usually go left to right and just bring it on down until I'm comfortable. If I do fill the whole nail and I feel like it's too bulky looking or there's gaps missing, then I'll start moving and removing and reapplying other size crystals as well. Also, just a reminder, you do apply the gummy jelly or any type of builder gel or any type of really thick gel on, and then apply the gel top coat on top of that, and do not cure either one until you're done applying all the crystals of your choice. And just double checking again, make sure it is as thin as possible, because if you don't do it thin, once you apply the nail with crystals, those crystals will end up sinking into that gel layer and that builder gel, and it'll take away the shine from the crystals. It will look like they're drowning in there, and that's not the point of doing crystals on the nail. You want to make sure that they look like they're literally flying, like right on top, like they're just laying there gently on top of the nail. So you want to prevent that by doing very thin layers. I also have a previous video that I just did on my channel on where I get my crystals from, both Michaels and AliExpress, and I do have links, and I show you the real versus the fake crystal so you can compare them. So don't forget to watch that video. I'll put it at the end of this video, and I'll also link it on my description box. And this is how the nail came out to look. It is really pretty. It's very different. Like I said, this is a lot of glam and bling, so it's not for everybody, but I'm just showing you guys how I do the nails with to my clients. Also, if you're wondering where I got the wax pencil, it is called a wax pencil, and I order these in bulk from AliExpress. I usually get 10 or 20 packs, and it's just a few dollars. It is really not expensive, and all you do is sharpen them with any sharpener you have, just like a pencil, and they're amazing. They work really, really well. For the bigger crystals, that's when I used either eyebrow pluckers or specific rhinestone picker uppers. So it really depends, but if I can find some similar, I'll link them down below as well. And then I use my top coat to top coat the pink from the French nail. You just gotta be very careful. You don't wanna overly apply this because it can go into the top of the crystals and take away the shine. So a quick tip I can recommend is always with your fingers, clean off the crystals from the top if it's just a few on the nail or close to the French line before going into the lamp to remove any excess gel or any gel that could have possibly got on top of the crystals. Here I'm going to be using a base, which is simply just nail glue, and I'm going to use a Seal Protect, which is an activator as well. Depends on every brand, everything's going to be called differently. So it is the Cura Sky brand I'm using here, and I'm just going to put the glue, the base, to adhere the crystals. And after I apply all the crystals to my liking and the design that I want, then I'll go in with the Seal Protect to fully dry the glue and harden it so they can stay on longer. And then after that, I will apply the top coat, which will fully seal the crystals from the sides. You do not want to overly apply this, like I said, or else it'll get on top. So this is the method that I use when I used a few crystals or when I just do some sort of crystal design. Anytime I use the big bulgy crystals or big type of crystals, that is when I go in with the gummy jelly and I apply a little dab of that and then put the crystal on top, cure it in the lamp, and then bring it right back. And then apply the rest of them. I like to secure the big crystals every time I apply them so that they don't move, because the gel will keep moving. When it comes to the glue, it'll hold them, but they will fully secure after I apply the Seal Protect or the activator. Another tip I can remember just now by looking is that before I put it in the lamp, the big crystals, I make sure I go in with a nice clean brush with some alcohol and acetone, or you can just do alcohol, and I clean the sides of the crystal so that no gel is bulging out and looks skunky and nasty. I want to prevent all that. Like I said, I want these crystals to look like they're floating on top of the nails. So I clean off the sides and then I put it in the lamp to cure it and secure it before moving on to doing other crystals on the nail. And here I just finished this nail design, so now I can go in with my activator and apply it onto the sides of the crystals. You can put this on top of the crystal, it will not remove any of the shine or damage it, but I usually try my best to keep it on the side so it can directly go in to the glue and harden and dry a lot faster. And then I will move on to the top coat here. And this is what I do, like I said, for any type of designs. It really depends on what the client wants, but this is what has worked for me and they have actually stayed on. I've always had trouble keeping crystals on when I first started, and I realized it's honestly just glue and an activator and it will hold them forever. You just gotta do it properly and make sure that you're being neat and generous with the glue, but not overly drowning the crystals in there, as well as doing the top coat, using your top coat to its advantage by helping the crystal seal from the sides but not overly drowning them. And for the last crystal nail design, I decided to not cure the bigger crystals just to show you. I usually don't cure the big crystals when I do some sort of straight line, simply because I could have put the crystal, the first one, off a little bit, and then everything else would just be off. So I'd rather wait until the end and move everything around, take my time before putting it in the lamp. But if it's any type of circle or any type around the cuticle or S design or anything like that, I usually cure as I go. So here I don't. I put on the big crystals and I kind of just decide whatever crystal designs I want to put on top of that. And then you'll see me. I keep moving things around, making sure I'm looking at it every direction to make sure it is a nice straight line or as straight as possible. And I do apply the regular crystals with the base, with the glue. I only do the big crystals with the gummy jelly or any type of builder gel is recommended. But any other regular crystal 16 size and below, I always do with just glue and an activator, and then just use the top coat to help that. And now we're gonna do my favorite part of every single acrylic nail set or any type of nails I do, is the top coat. I know I'm off frame here. I was just too focused on polishing that I did not see that I was off frame the camera, so I apologize for that. Now I only put the top coat on the French nail and on the nail on my pinky and on my index finger, and that was it. Well, not mine, my mannequins. I do not put the top coat on the full crystal nail because there's no need when the top coat is already there with the gummy jelly right underneath. And this will just help seal the crystals even more, plus give you that shiny top coat. You can definitely use a matte top coat as well. That works just the same. It really depends on the look you're going for. I really hope this video helped you guys, at least made you see different ways you can apply it. And hopefully this works for you and it helps keep your crystals on longer, especially if you're buying the real Swarovski crystals, and it should be worth every single penny and should last you. But thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you guys in my next video. Don't forget to watch other videos that I have uploaded recently, and let me know in your comments how you like the set and if you learned anything from this. Thanks guys.